I'm saying that African belief systems, properly understood, is 10 times better than Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. And better for the African.
Tap into your spirituality. My church is KREST, K-R-S-T. They teach African spiritual science, okay? And that's where I get my strength from. And as black people, I want to encourage you to go back to your roots and find your creator.
I was raised by my mom. My pops raised me too, but I lived with my mom. So, you know, the culture that I was in my house was American culture, American black culture. But I always knew my name was Aramis Askedon. So just from school, from elementary school, you know what I'm saying, there wasn't no, you know, not understanding that, you know, who I was as far as through my pops.
His mama named him Nipsey. I'm going to call him Sweet Feet.
That's my real name. That's a rap name.
Oh, well, your mama didn't name you Nipsey.
Yeah.
But what's your name then?
My real name, it means God will rise. It's Aramis, though. That's how you say it.
Oh, that's how you say Aramis?
Aramis, yeah.
Aramis. Aramis.
Yeah.
How do you say your last name?
Askedon.
I was like, how do you say Askedon?
That's sexy.
Yeah, okay. That's right.
Nope, I'm right here because
I feel like you could have went with that.
That's sexy. Yeah. Askedon? That's good.
I feel like you could have went with your real name.
I could have.
That's too hard.
I could have.
I don't know. Nowadays,
I'm going to be answering questions a lot.
Yeah. Yo, so
I just found out a few years ago what my name meant, too. You know, the whole time. I didn't know it had a meaning behind
it. Who brought that to you? Who?
One of my homegirls. We were just riding around, and she was like, what do your name mean? And I'm like, it's just an African name. It don't got no meaning. She like, you sound crazy. She Googled it. And she like, look, nigga. And I was like, damn, that's powerful. God will rise. I mean a lot, you know?
Mm-hmm. Wow. Yeah. That just happened for you?
Nah, I was probably like 27, 28, a couple years ago.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Why is it that Nipsey Hussle promotes and wears Puma clothing, but he sells Marathon clothing?
Pressure on your shoulder. How you gonna deal with it?
Jesus' family line, in terms of as a dynasty, was the Hasmonean dynasty at the time. And their symbol of their household was a panther, a black panther.
I mean, the plan was to lock this paperwork in today.
Yeah.
And, you know, I talked to Jeff G last night, and we decided it was going to come through early.
I like that.
So I'm like, let's kill two birds with one stone.
That part.
So, you know, we announcing our partnership with Puma. You know, we got a big deal.
We suffered through this. The world would not know Jesus Christ if there was never Judas. Evidence of a divine presence. Blessings.
Talk to me about your shirt.
Oh, reactivists. I wore this one because what we have become are reactivists to a whole bunch of shit. Mm. You know what I'm saying? We have exalted. This man has become the Christ of our time.
Well, Jermaine Dupri literally said that.
Yeah, this nigga is the reborn Christ. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Once we start talking like that, you're goofy. You need to get your head checked. Mm. You know what I mean?
I would just say, you know, master your energy. Do your best to master your energy and what you put out, you know? Unless that's what you want. You know, because you're entitled to whatever you want to create, whatever experience you want to create for yourself. But if you're tired of that shit, adjust the energy. You know what I mean? As best you can. Adjust what you wake up thinking and what you say. And then, lastly, what you do. And that's not an easy thing to do because it's such a pressure in these areas to just go by the way things are. But, you know, it's a lot of examples that you could look up to as young kids in the streets. You could look up to Kendrick Lamar. Not the words, forget what he's saying, just where he came from. I seen him, you could YouTube him freestyling in the Nickerson Garden Projects. You could look up to a Nip Hussle. You know, you could look up to a YG, you know what I mean? To a Top Dog, you know what I mean? To any one of these guys that came from this hopelessness. And you know, wiggle their way through it. You know what I mean? And you can reverse engineer what they did. You know, look at the steps, what happened. You know, so I would say that.
Whatever you do, you from over there, Nipsey inspired you, bro. Because as far as a gangbanger, he did that. Let's be 100. As far as a businessman, he did that. As far as a father, he did that. As far as an entrepreneur, he did that. So he actually did every field. Like I said, from 9 to 5, he did the square shit. He did the gangbang. And then he showed you that all of that is cool, bro. The highest human act is to inspire, like he said, rest in peace, King Nipsey.